Hey, welcome to the video tutorial comparison shopping. This tutorial is for intermediate level Java developers who want to add comparison and sorting capabilities to the custom classes they've created for their projects. So let's get started. The files used in this tutorial are available on GitHub at the link provided. Please download them if you'd like to follow along. When you need sorted collections of objects in your Java applications, if a database is available, you can run queries returning ordered results, which you can then convert into an automatically ordered collection of Java objects. That's an easy, often high-performing solution. But if that isn't an option for whatever reason, you need to write code for objects to know how to compare themselves with each other in memory. To learn how to do this, it's helpful to look at core Java classes as a model. For example, let's see how things work with String in our Comparison Shopper class. The code is really simple. We create a generic array list of String and add three strings representing makes of car, Mercedes, Audi, and BMW, in that order. Then we sort the list and print out the results. Let's run the code and see what happens. As you can see, the list is sorted alphabetically as you would expect. It just worked. But how? To get answers like this, you always need to look at the Java docs available online or through your IDE. Let's take a look at the Java doc for String. Check out the interfaces String implements. Comparable String. That looks relevant. Let's see what that is. Comparable looks pretty popular with a lot of implementing classes. According to the Java doc, Comparable imposes a total ordering on the objects of each class that implements it. So we need to implement the compareTo method in Comparable. The JavaDoc specification for compareTo has typically cumbersome wording, but basically, you compare the current object with the one passed in as a parameter. If the current object is bigger, return 1. If it's smaller, return -1. If they're equal, return 0. That's it. Notice also that because Comparable is generic, you have a compile time guarantee that the parameter to compare to will be the same type as your object. If you even tried to mess with it because you were really bored, you would get errors when you compile and maybe even immediately in your editor. Getting feedback before runtime saves you a lot of time, which is helpful when you have deadlines at work. So strings are sortable out of the box because String implements the compare to method in Comparable. Let's do the same thing with our own custom class. Here is a very simple class car with just a make and a price. Since we want to be able to sort a collection of cars, we implement comparable on car, which means we need to implement a compareTo method with a car parameter. Let's look at that method. The first thing we do is some error checking. As a practical matter, a null parameter or a mistyped parameter due to class loading issues will probably never happen. But if you go back and look, the specification in the Java doc for compareTo describes how you should handle weird cases like these. Just as we have here, always honor the spec. Anyway, the rest of the method is much more interesting. Since we already did some string sorting, this time let's decide we want our cars to be sorted on price from lowest to highest. If the price of this car is less than the price of the car in the parameter, we return -1. If it's greater, we return 1. If we're still here, the two prices must be equal, so we return 0. Pretty easy. Let's go back to Comparison Shopper to see how it all works. Similar to before, we create an array list, this time of car objects, and sort it. Looking at the prices of these elite makes, which make me sad for obvious reasons, we expect the order to be BMW, Audi, Mercedes, from low to high price. And that's what we see. So there you have it. By implementing Comparable, the car class is now sortable. That wasn't too tough. This is enough to get by most of the time, so you're welcome to quit watching and play with the code. But we have to cover two more topics, consistency with equals and alternate comparisons, so you can have the elite understanding that'll make it the envy of the cube farm and a hit at parties. On consistency with equals, let's go back to the Java doc for comparable. Expert Java developers know they're supposed to override equals, and hash code for that matter, for all their custom classes. As you can see, the Java doc has the usual complicated wording, but all it says is that if two comparable objects are equal as calculated by the equals method, then compareTo with the same two objects should return 0, and vice versa. Let's go back to the code for car. Here are compareTo again and equals. As you can see, once we get past all the equals method boilerplate code you have, we define equality with a compareTo call returning 0. Note the explicit cast of the object parameter to type car, which we can safely do after passing the checks above. So compareTo and equals are consistent. This isn't required, and you might be able to get away with being inconsistent. But as the Java doc points out, a lot of weird things can happen with core Java collections like sorted set and sorted map. Also, who knows what might happen with collections found in third-party libraries like Google Guava and Apache Commons collections. Spare yourself the debugging on the weekend and just take the 5 minutes to get this right. The last thing we need to cover is alternate comparisons. We use comparable to define what's called the natural order of a class. In other words, how we want things to be sorted by default. For strings, the natural order is alphabetical. For our cars, the natural order is by price. What if that works most of the time, but there are some cases where we need to sort on something different than the natural ordering, like sorting a list of strings by length every now and then, or sorting our cars by make. For situations like this, we use a comparator. While comparable is in the java.lang package, comparator is an interface in the java.util package, which means you need to import it explicitly. But as you can see from the Java doc, it looks a lot like comparable. It is an interface with a generic comparison method and the same contractual obligations. The key differences are the name of the method compare and that it takes two generically typed parameters. A separate class entirely, not string or car, implements comparator and gets passed along when it's time to sort a collection. Let's see how this works. MakeComparator is a class whose sole purpose is to enable us to sort cars on make, while car retains its natural ordering on price. Compare takes the two car parameters and first handles some edge cases that will probably never happen, but then it does a neat thing. Since the make of a car is a string, and strings implement comparable, we can actually take advantage of the natural ordering of strings to achieve an alternate ordering for car by make. This makes for a simple one-line comparison. To use MakeComparator, let's go back to Comparison Chopper. We create the same list of cars, but this time we call an overloaded version of collections.sort where we pass in the collection and an instance of MakeComparator. When the sort method sees this, it knows to ignore the natural ordering on car defined by compareTo and to use the ordering defined by MakeComparator instead. Let's run the code and see what happens. You can see the difference when sorting on natural order and sorting with a comparator. And with that, you are now an expert on creating your own Java objects that can be sorted within any kind of collection on any dimension. Let's summarize. In order to make your custom Java classes sortable, they need to implement the comparable interface. The compareTo method in comparable is where you define the class's natural ordering, what makes one instance of your class less than, equal to, or greater than another. It's up to you what the natural order should be for your class. Take the time to implement compareTo exactly as the specification states to avoid nasty problems later, even though you might be able to get away without doing it. If you need to be able to sort your objects in a different way, beyond their natural ordering, write a class that implements comparator and pass an instance of the collections.sort method. If you haven't already, don't forget to download the files used in this tutorial from GitHub and explore the code for yourself. You will never learn technology listening to someone talk. Getting your hands dirty is the only way to do it. We really hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned enough to add comparison and sorting to your Java code. Java is a rich language with a lot of terrific features, and we will explore many of them in greater detail in future tutorials and blog posts on the Vidya website. We hope you will check those out too. Thanks for watching. This has been Comparison Chopping by Vidya.